Okay, so my last video that I made yesterday or a couple days ago, I was talking about the new DaVinci Resolve 16 object removal feature, and it kind of did mediocre job. And in this video, what I want to do more in-depth about this tool, and I know it's still in beta, so I'm giving them, benefit of a doubt. And basically, I want to see how this object remove stands out against program like Mocha. If you guys don't know what the Mocha is, it's basically a very high-end planner tracker where you can remove objects, where you can do like different kind of stuff like rotoscoping. Basically, it's like high-end tool for this kind of stuff. So I want to do remove inside DaVinci Resolve, and I want to do remove inside Mocha. And basically, the way I'm going to be doing the remove, I'm going to be using automated feature. I'm not going to go, high-end into like legit rotoscoping. I'm gonna take this from the perspective of the average user, just like exactly Blackmagic Design aiming. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go into the Mocha, and we see we have exactly identical shot here. And basically, I'm gonna try to remove this using default features, basically in Mocha, without painting any kind of plates manually or doing anything like that. Here in Mocha, the first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do a background tracking. So I'm gonna select the plane. And by the way, if you by any chance want to see like Mocha tutorials, I can make some of them. I used to do this kind of stuff more professionally. So this one I'm gonna call plane. Let's see. Double click. I don't do those kind of stuff too often now, so I'm a little bit disoriented. All right, so we have this feature called track, and we have minimal pixels used. 30 is not enough, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna increase this to, let's say, 95. And we have transition, scale, rotation, and shear. And in this clip, none of that's going on, so I'm gonna deselect all of them. We have relatively, I mean, small motion is okay, I guess. And what I'm going to try to do is track it automatically and see if this thing actually going to do a decent job at it. So I'm going to grab a decent piece of footage. Okay, something like that. Okay, obviously larger the surface, slower your computer go, but the better track supposed to be. So let's see. And let's track forward. Okay, we can see it's kind of tiny bit skewing a little bit, but let's leave it like that, and let's basically pretend like we average users, we have no real idea what's going on in terms of like actually tracking. So it's doing an alright job, not too bad. Even though technically I should have masked her out, but it's fine. From the perspective again from average user. Okay, so the plane is finished. Let's scroll back really quick. All right, I say that's good enough track. Let's uncheck this little gear. That way we're not going to be tracking this over. And now what I'm going to do, go to the middle somewhere, and basically I'm going to now select the hiker, and we're going to start tracking the hiker. I'm gonna try to do very rough selection, something like this. Okay, something like that. And again, track 90%. We have large motion. Let's see if this thing can identify the hiker for us. Unfortunately, no. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna delete tracks. Call this one hiker. All right, and I'm gonna start manually tracking. So let me do this thing big enough that way The tracking is very simple, basically like this. I'm gonna do keyframe here. And move it here, keyframe here. Kinda just very, very basic tracking. And I know some of the professional rotoscopers out there and, you know, whoever doing CGI, they're probably looking at me like, ew, this guy. But, okay, you know, I wanna basically do it from the perspective of the average user that doesn't know CGI that well. And I'm sure this is exactly what Blackmagic Design aiming for, so I think it's gonna be good. More. And as you can see, I mean, my mask is pretty huge. Okay, like that. I just want to make sure that our hiker inside this little mask throughout the whole tracking. This is what I'm trying to get from this. Okay, that is great. All right, here. Okay, so now let's do save. And little by little, I'm gonna start playing it back. And we still have to do manual fixing. Okay, that looks good. Okay, add keyframe. It's going. So far so good. Up, right there. Frame. Perfect. Right there. Tedious process. I mean, there is no way around it. It's a very tedious process. Remove it unless you're removing something as simple as like boom microphone in the shot, then you can just use whatever program. Okay, so let's save. So we have a hiker now. Let's go to remove tab, and I'm gonna start from the last frame, and basically I'm gonna leave default values in this whole thing, and let's see how well it's gonna do the job. So I'm ready to click this little gear, and let's find out. Okay, so far pretty well. What I'm looking for in my previous video, there was a little bit artifact going on. I think it was shadow that was kind of funky looking. So I want to make sure in this particular situation we don't have any kind of funky things going around. I'm looking in this video for the quality. So as we can see, knock on the wood, so far Mocha doing fantastic job removing the hiker. And I'm gonna play it back, and we're gonna see if this is gonna be actually usable if we do like a indie movie or documentary or something where the quality is important. So far I think it looks fantastic. It looks very clean. Let's see how well it's gonna hold on. And by the way, it's very important whenever you do noise remove or any kinds of stuff like that, make sure that your footage don't have any kind of artificial grain added. Make sure you're working with the cleanest possible plate. Also, if you're doing any kind of noise reduction, make sure you don't have anything being skewed, especially by DaVinci built-in noise reduction, because in their case, sometimes they kind of have that thing going on where motion becoming blurry. So make sure you don't have that selected when you do this kind of stuff. Okay, it's almost over. All right, I'm gonna save it. And let me zoom in, tools, zoom, and let's play it back and basically see. All right, a little bit here I see, like very, very tiny bit. Look, see, kind of like very, very minute. Okay, let's keep on going. Good. All right, you know what, For the quality that I've done, for completely just like random and very garbage mask and whatnot, I'm gonna give this 10 out of 10. I think it did fantastic job removing. So Mocha in this case is, you know, passed the test for simplicity. Now Davinci Resolve. Again, let's make sure it's the same shot. Here's basically all the grading that I've done, exactly same what we see in Mocha. Okay, gonna save the project. So what I'm gonna do now is very similar. I'm gonna do relatively large mask around the hiker because I don't expect the users that this feature aimed at to be like really crazy with rotoscoping. Okay, let's go tracking frame, and basically it's gonna be a manual track. Okay, let's first do very rough. Okay, like this. And probably if you would use some kind of a tablet like a Wacom I have over here, your tracking gonna be faster, but again, I wanna do sort of average Joe style. I don't wanna be going too high tech with it. All right. Hopefully it will stick around. This. Done. Okay. And first frame. All right. So now let me save again because it's beta and it's unstable. Let me play back. I want to make sure that we doing the same high quality. Oh, right here. We're gonna move a little bit like that. I want to make sure that our hiker exactly inside the frame, that we don't not cheating or anything like that. Okay. All right. Well enough. Perfect. So this one tracking. Okay. And this one again, we're gonna do remove. And we're gonna pass all that information over here. All right. And let's save it. Let's go into open effects. Da 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 da. Object remove. Where are you? There we go. Okay, let's do scene analysis. Takes a little bit of time, but hopefully result gonna be good. Okay, 90, 95. Come on, come on, come on. Okay. And let's click build clean plate. And we can see again we have a very weird kind of exoskeleton from Metal Gear going on.
Self-camouflage? Who are you?
We can see that it didn't do such a great of a job. Let me zoom in. And there's a lot of artifacts going on. So this particular shot is not usable. Now, to give benefit of a doubt, because it's beta, I'm hoping obviously they're gonna fix it. Let me delete this remove. Let me go in actual tracking node and let me try to do object removal on the actual node to see if this is gonna do a better job. Okay, let's do again scene analysis. Also, in my opinion, the object removal, they should have a OFX tab for fusion rather than color grading, because object remove, even though it's part of the color grading, but I feel like it's more part of the fusion actually, because technically it's CGI, but we'll see. All right, so again, build clean plate. Okay. And this one looks even worse than the previous one. So obviously, clearly Mocha is the winner. Mocha did fantastic job. giving all benefit of a doubt that because this is very raw beta, I mean, it just came out pretty much a couple days ago, they're gonna fix it. As of right now, I think this whole feature is a gimmick, and I probably will not be using this until it's addressed or fixed. But I just wanted to give a comparison, let's say, for indie filmmakers, if they need to remove something, to kind of show them what they're gonna get with this software. So thank you guys for watching. I'll be making more videos on DaVinci Resolve 16 in the near future, pretty much in a couple days. So be sure to subscribe, and I will see you soon. Take care.